Hello, beauties.
Hello, champions. It's me, Jay. Happy Sunday! Woo! Yes! All right, guys. We have made it to day number 7 of the water fast. Yes! It has been a week of this water fast. And not every day was smooth, but most days were. I didn't have any hunger at all. What I did have is some mental hunger, where I decided, or I saw something and it made me feel like I needed to get something to eat, but I physically was not hungry, so I ignored that. I let that come through and I asked myself, why are you eating? Are you hungry? Or do you just want to feed yourself because you see something? So I did not eat. So here I am at day 7. And you can see my stomach has definitely gone down. So that's great. All is well, and I'm happy about that. So I wanted to talk to you guys about your fast. You guys, you have to fast for yourself. Do what works for you, not for anybody else, not because someone else is doing it. Get motivated by other people because we need that. But then listen to your body and make sure your body is okay, that you're checking in, that everything is groovy. Okay? Make sure you do that. Okay, I told you guys that I was going to do 15 days, but I've decided I cannot do 15 days because on November the 6th, I am going to Vipassana meditation course. I'm going to do a whole video on that and what it looked like. But the reason why I'm going to stop my fast before the 6th is, I think I was supposed to fast up to the 4th or 5th or something like that. I don't know. But I need my body to get back in check and eat whatever it's going to eat and be okay and not run into the bathroom because I can't control what I eat. They're going to feed us this vegetarian food. That can be a lot of salads. It could be, you know, I don't know, potatoes. I have no idea, but I know when I usually break my fast, I break it very slowly and allow myself to come back into eating. I do it with fruit and things of that nature. I think last time, did I do it with, I think I've been doing, breaking my fasts with fruit the whole time. But my main reason for that is because I don't want to be at this location where I have very little control of what I do and how I can operate and not be able to know what my body and how it's reacting. During this meditation course, we will be meditating like 11 hours. There's no talking, no phones, no communication at all. there's no eye contact. There's no checking in on your family. There's no reading. There's nothing that you're doing but focusing on this course and learning the method of this meditation and learning your body and listen to your body. So this is a perfect time for me to be with my brain and to clear my mind and to really get in touch with things that's going on with me and to, you know, visualize and really get clear. And I can't wait. I can't wait. I know to everybody it sounds like, oh my God, you're what? This is crazy. But I'm excited about it and I can't wait. So I'm going to, I don't know if I'm going to, I probably fast this whole week going up to it and probably stop on Friday or Saturday. I haven't really decided what that looked like because I do want to make sure my body's okay, break my fast and do everything so that my body is okay because I will not have control of what I eat. I cannot bring food. You cannot go out for food. You're pretty much there and you're submitting yourself to this course and the teachers and everybody in that realm. So I want to prepare for that and prepare mentally for giving up so much control of myself. So anywho, I will tell you guys all about it when I come back. I can't wait, can't wait, can't wait. I know my friends are like, what? You're not going to be able to talk and laugh? You? Oh my God. It's going to be fine. Okay, so the other thing I wanted to tell you guys is that this week I will be adding vitamins and I will add my concoction of pink salt, vinegar, and water. I will show you guys. I'll do a whole video on that. And my reason for that, when I fast 40 days and 31 days or 31 and 40 days and blah, 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 I deprived my body of so many minerals that I had. Let me first say this before I say that. I had a bald spot on my scalp that was really small when I first went natural. It was like this. And I knew that I needed to stop using chemicals in my hair. So I went to a dermatologist, and I knew beforehand she was going to say, don't put any more chemicals in your hair, perm, whatever. So I had prepared myself and stopped doing that. So in doing the whole thing with my dermatologist, she gave me an injection in my scalp. She did some other things to my scalp, medication, special shampoo, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so that stuff didn't work for me, really. And the spot was still there. So I started to take care of my hair myself using oils. And that's when I came up with my company of making natural hair products. Okay, if you guys didn't know that about me, I do. But I haven't. I did that. That's why the whole channel is named Nappy Beauty. And if you go back to my old videos, that's all I talked about was hair and that type of stuff. Okay, so fast forward. I stopped making my products. Really stopped taking care of my hair the way I did when I was first natural and just a fanatic about it. Okay. And then fast forward to when I fast. So one thing that fasting does, if there's something going on with your body like that didn't heal or that is in need of healing, the fast will bring that out and it will get worse before it gets better. So in fasting, all that time, depriving myself of the minerals, my body's going to take care of the vital organs first, hair, whatever. So in doing that, because my body knows what it needs, I lost a lot of hair, like in the center of my head, somewhere in that area. And it was very thin, okay? To the point that there's like a, it's not bald, but there's a patch and it's very, very, very thin, little hair growing. But during the fast, so that cleared out. And now my body is regrowing all of that because the fast cleared it and it's doing what it's doing and healing it. So I have this issue going on and my hair is growing. And I wore crochet for, I don't know, most of this year, I think I've been in crochet and not really taking care of my hair. I would take it out, wash it, condition it, and do that. But I'm right back in. So I haven't gave my hair enough love this year. So that being said, I'm thinking that I'm going to lock